Hey guys, so today I thought I would do a vlog. I tried to do actually two videos today, one for my vlog channel, one for my main channel, and they were just dead. They didn't work out whatsoever, and so I was really disappointed in that. And so I thought, since given the opportunity now, I would try again and record a whole new vlog. Just I guess talking about just updates about my life, I guess. I know I give them a lot, but I never really feel like talking about anything else on this channel, given the fact that my daily life, just how my energy always is, how low my energy always is, and how my life always is, kind of overrules the majority of how I speak in my videos. And so, and it overrules my mind a lot of the time, unfortunately. You know, like I can make myself still, think positively and have positive outlooks on life and all of that, and still do my manifestation trainings and all of that, and keep up with all of that sort of stuff to make sure that my life is going in a good direction for the future. But still, my life still is not that great as of right now, because manifestation takes time, and because some people don't take the time to educate themselves in this area of things, so they just give up. But I did educate myself for years on this stuff, and trust me, I was one of the most stubborn people to wake up, okay, to teach this stuff to, right? In other words, waking up. And a lot of people can be stubborn too. There's a great majority of people out there can be stubborn, but fair enough, because we all go through so much shit. And because of that negative shit, we don't want to hear that. We can choose how we think. We can choose how we feel, because that is probably one of the worst things. In fact, that's actually sometimes why I even feel like shit, because it's like I know I can choose something else. And having that awareness on the plus side, though, is always a good thing. Even if you don't successfully shift your thoughts, it's just good that you're aware. That's already a step forward, right? But it is hard to switch that sometimes, and especially when you have like no energy. Like, I never have any fucking energy ever, ever, ever. So it's like I do get random bursts of energy, but for the most part, it's really, really hard to find. And oh, it's just kind of awful. And yeah, like it kind of sucks, but it's how it is right now. And that's why I can talk about my personal life a little more on this channel than doing just, I guess, other. They'd still be personal videos on this channel I still have planned, but like not about necessarily anything that's being negative in my life. Like, but when that shit's overruling in my life, it's the only thing on my mind 24/7, right? Because other than that, then it's the hope for a better future. And that's what I'm constantly working towards. But until then, like, it's not just a go to college and fix your life kind of thing. Unfortunately, some people do have it that easy. But trying to, do things in the creative industry of things, especially YouTube, being a YouTuber, that. Not easy, okay? No. It's definitely probably one of the hardest things I'm gonna say for if you want it in your life forever, like as a fucking lifestyle rather than a traditional job or a traditional anything and everything, that most people do choose. And even like, I feel like even musicians and actors and actresses even have it quite a bit easier, because all you have to do is go to auditions constantly and try and impress like 5 people, maybe even 10 people. YouTube, you're alone, bitch. You fucking have to impress the whole world to get your fucking career, okay? The whole fucking world. At least half of it to be that successful with YouTube, right? So it's quite a bit more challenging. I just feel like it's fair enough to say that. It's far more challenging than going to college or university and then impressing a group of a few people. And same with, again, singing and acting, impressing a few people. Once you've impressed those people, you're fucking set, bitch. Like, of course, like, if sometimes you may not get like an awesome movie or TV show. Some people are quite fortunate to get the opportunity to, be on really good TV shows. Like, I know there's some people that are new to acting that are on some really successful TV shows or really successful movies when they first start acting, and so that's a huge opportunity. But sometimes it may not happen like that. Sometimes you may have to try again and try again and try again until you get that movie or TV show that really hits it off for you. So, you know, but still, it's really difficult with YouTube. It's not impressing a few people. It's impressing like over a million people. You know, it's not, and you do not have a movie, people directing and editing movies for you to hope that they can blast off your career. Like, YouTubers don't really get that opportunity. They're all on their own for the editing. They're all on their own for making thumbnails. They're all on their own for their video ideas and the content that they come out with. It is all on the YouTuber. And I really feel like YouTubers are kind of underrated and misunderstood in that way, because they have to work harder than lots of people do, you know? Like, it's fair to say, I think so, because they have to do everything by hand. They have to sit there for hours and work, 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 work. They never fucking get to stop. And then there's people who literally have to work quite a few hours less and bitch about YouTubers having everything. And it doesn't make any sense. I don't get it. I never have understood that, but I guess life can work that way. But, you know, apart from those things, it's just, it is a longer journey. It takes time, right? And so, like, for me, all the things that I want to do involve the creative industry. So I have to work really, really hard, and I have to wait and be patient, right? Because these things take time, and they do take patience, and they do take endless amount of work, no matter what part of the creative industry it is in. I'm just saying that it's a lot easier when someone gives you a little boost. YouTubers don't really get that, like, until maybe 5 years, 4 years, 4 years, 5 years of being on YouTube, you know? Sometimes then they meet other really successful YouTubers that give them boosts and shit and do collabs with them, whatever. But until then, they're really on their own. And even sometimes still then, they still kind of, you know, it takes a while for the message to get out about them, and then people start subscribing. The more collabs they do with bigger YouTubers, like, it just takes time, right? And whereas with acting and singing and all of that stuff, there's even colleges for that, fucking universities for that. There is none of that for YouTube. There's an online course, but money issues, obviously, and no one in my life supports it enough to ever even consider paying for that. I mean, like, everything I want to do, nobody wants me to do. So I have to work solo, continuously, on my own, 24/7. But that's fine. I'm fine with that. It's just that, obviously, like, when you are in a place of pain and you're kind of suffering continuously, you do want your life to get better. Sorry, my hair's a little wild today. It's kind of doing what it wants. It's almost time for my day to wash it, but, you know, until then, it's kind of doing whatever the fuck it wants to. After day two, it just goes crazy and does whatever it wants to. Fuck, my hair recurled itself overnight. Like, I don't even know how that's possible, but it happens. But back on topic, these things do take a long time. And for, like, YouTube and, you know, even starting your own business, like, I want to do so many things, YouTube being one of them, and they all take your own time. They all take your own hard work, your own support. Like, you might go a lifetime without support before being successful in these things, right? And you have to start from zero with these things, right? Like, for the things I want to do, there is no fucking college or university. There is no going to auditions and impressing people and hoping that they can help me get successful in my careers that I desire in my life. There is none of that shit. There is none of those opportunities. There is only hopes of meeting people that are on the same path and journey that I am, and they're willing to help me and give me boosts because they're just that awesome and they just want to see me grow as I do for everyone else. And definitely, you know, like, it would be awesome, but, you know, it's more rare than it is. Like, it doesn't happen as often as it can for singers or actors and actresses. Like, it just, you can walk into a room and the opportunity can be handed to you. And if you don't get it that time, you can keep doing it until you fucking do, right? And at least there's the hope for that. But making videos, the world is completely deciding your fate, right? So it's like, And again, you can keep trying or give up. And that's what it comes down to. And of course, I'm never going to give up YouTube. YouTube is like the only reason that makes me feel a sense of purpose. It's the only reason I still live and breathe. It is like my fucking oxygen. And literally, since day one I've ever been on YouTube, YouTube has been my oxygen. Like, there has been some things on YouTube that have kind of scared me and traumatized me as a kid, funny enough, but I got over them, whatever. I was just scared of everything as a fucking kid. That's probably why I'm not so scared of that much things now, but I was terrified of even things on YouTube. Like, it, literally, how YouTubers have, like, the colorful thumbnails, that scared me. Literally, I remember one of them was, Shane Dawson's videos. I would always see Shane Dawson's thumbnails, and I don't know, like, it's more so, like, the color yellow scared me. Like, because to me, I always felt, like, warning and, like, caution when I seen the colors red and yellow, so when he had the yellow in his thumbnails and, like, a shocked look on his face, it terrified the fuck out of me. So that's kind of my life, and that's kind of how it turned out. Of course, I don't do that anymore. I don't have that issue anymore, but it can happen. It did happen as a kid, and now it just doesn't, but that's okay, I guess. But I don't know. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. This, I just constantly lost my train of thought, whatever. That's, I don't even know. But I was watching some of my older videos, and then I started watching Dance Moms. That helped me forget about a lot of things, and I don't even know why, because mostly that show just kind of, it just makes me uncomfortable and angry, because it's like, nobody's really fucking mature in that show. They have their moments. All of them do. The kids and the moms and the dance instructor. But, well, and I get it. They're kind of probably paid to be dramatic. I assume that's how those shows work, but, you know, like, I don't find any of them necessarily mature, but, or I mean, I don't find them completely immature, but I don't find them mature either. They're kind of both. Like, they constantly switch from mature and immature, in my opinion, and that's kind of irritating and amusing at the same time, I guess. Part of what the show's kind of about, but you know, apart from that, it's, I kind of just started watching it. I only watched, like, a few clips of it on, like, YouTube. I'm kind of too lazy to go and actually watch the show, but, like, a genius would, but it hasn't been suiting me, so I haven't done it yet. But maybe I'm also just a little insecure of people literally just hearing a bunch of angry moms screaming from my TV, and then they're like, what the fuck are you watching? So I don't know, that kind of also crossed my mind a bit too, because it's like, they've done it before. Literally, I had a video, one of Shane's videos on, and everyone's just like, what the fuck are you even watching? And it's like, YouTubers? So, you know, but that happens. And so, ever since those moments have come up, I've just been kind of feeling a little insecure about watching Dance Moms through my actual TV, because I can do that if I wanted to, but then people are going to be questioning why there's a bunch of angry women screaming from my TV and just yelling at each other. That's all that show is, and I feel so bad for the kids on that show. It's like they're just surrounded by yelling all the time, and who wants that? I don't know, but truthfully, it did make me feel better. And lately, it has been making me feel better, but, you know, it was helping me forget about all my troubles in life somewhat. Maybe it helped me actually kind of view that they've had worse than me, in the sense of being surrounded by, I mean, I guess I was surrounded by yelling, like, all the time for quite some time in my life, but they can walk away is a different story. I couldn't, so difference, and I can't either, because that shit still kind of goes on around me, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. This video is taking forever, it's going on forever, it's never ending. So I think maybe I'll just end it here. I hope tomorrow's videos are interesting and actually work out quite well, and my hair's not a bitch to me. I don't know what's gonna, oh, I'm scared. I'm scared to see what's gonna happen with that, because You know, I have a habit of touching my hair because I used to really want like these like Ariel bangs. And so, short story, I used to really want these like Ariel bangs, and Ariana Grande had the bangs too. So, you know, and everyone just had these awesome bangs, and it just like, you know, it was kind of, they were kind of like emo bangs, but they weren't really, because like the girls would like go like this to their bangs, and then it would kind of like, I guess, kind of do this really cool thing at the top of their head. I can't even explain it, but it looked awesome and I liked it. But I never had enough hair to do it, and I still don't have enough hair to do it because my baby hairs grow slowly as fuck. So I don't know. I still feel like when I can have that hair, I'm going to have that hair because I really love playing with my hair because it's long and all of that. And you know, that's why I play with my hair a lot, because now it's just become a habit. They did it to my hair actually a little bit, but it would always kind of like destroy itself after a while, because my hair, like, every time I've gone to the hairdresser, I'm with my sister, of course, because she is a professional hairdresser, but she's not in hairdressing anymore. But I don't know, she still has like her license and all of that. But even she, everyone that's ever been a professional hairdresser that has ever done my hair, touched my hair, you know, even when I was taking, you know, hair classes in high school, it's like everyone's just like, you know, you don't have a part, right? And it's like, yeah, I know. And they're like, do you want one? And I tell them, yeah, that would be nice, thanks. And then they give me a part, and then it disappears after that day. Like, literally, my hair is the most stubborn thing you'll ever meet in your life. And you know, a lot of people don't listen to me when I tell them about it, but it's a thing, and they usually find out the hard way. Eventually, they find out, but my hair does not like to be dealt with in any way that it's just not okay with. And I try to tell people, but they don't listen, and then my hair teaches them, and then they're like, oh, and I'm like, yeah. So it kind of just happens on its own. It does whatever it wants. Like I said, my hair literally has curled itself overnight, and nothing has happened to it. So, you know, my hair perfectly dry, everything, and it just curls itself again. I don't understand, but all right, that can happen. I'm going to stop rambling now and just end the video. And like I said, hopefully tomorrow's videos are more interesting and go better. Jeez, see, need to end it right now. So if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And if you guys have any video recommendations for me at all, any questions for me, be sure to let me know in the comments below this video. And lastly, I will always add, as I always do in my videos, that I will link my main channel, that's my main channel, in the description below this video.